Hi, in this video we are going to talk about nested PCR. You can find written notes on what we are going to discuss today at medicinecanbeeasy.com. The link is also in the description. Before we look at how to do nested PCR, I would like you to understand the reason why we want to do it in the first place and why a standard PCR doesn't suffice. Remember that the point of doing PCR is to amplify a specific DNA sequence, which can then be analyzed using various methods, such as electrophoresis, for example. To do this, we need a set of primers that are complementary to the ends of our sequence, DNA polymerase to synthesize the sequence, and a thermocycler, a special machine that allows us to quickly change temperature and therefore carry out the three PCR steps: denaturation, annealing, and extension. If you feel lost, please go back to our video on standard PCR where we explain everything in detail. What can sometimes happen when you do a PCR is that the primers were not specific enough, and that they bound to a different sequence that we did not want them to. This creates what we call a non-specific product of PCR, a PCR product that does not contain the specific DNA sequence we wanted. So the whole point of nested PCR is to allow us to be much more specific, and the key to getting a specific product is to use two sets of primers. Let's take a look and see how this works in more detail. Nested PCR actually consists of two PCR reactions. Each reaction uses a different set of primers. We start the first PCR with denaturation, when we heat the DNA to high temperatures and cause the two DNA strands to separate. Now, in annealing, we use the so-called external primers. External primers are primers that are designed to be complementary to a sequence that is outside the DNA sequence we want to amplify. Of course, it is still very close to it and of course includes the sequence of our interest. By doing so, we get a slightly larger product in extension when DNA polymerase synthesizes the two DNA strands. Why do we do this? Well, imagine now that the external primers we used were not specific enough, and that we now have a mixture of the DNA sequence we wanted and of some other DNA sequence that we never intended to amplify. If this was standard PCR, you would sometimes have to start all over again and change the annealing temperature, for example, or do other changes. But in nested PCR, we do another round of the reaction. Once again, denaturation, separating the two DNA strands, and then annealing. But this time, we use a different set of primers, called internal primers, that are designed in a way that they are complementary directly to the DNA sequence we want to amplify. And what's the point? Well, if there is, in fact, a mix of products, these primers will anneal only to the complementary sequence we designed them for, and not the other products of the first PCR reaction. It would be extremely unlikely that there would once again be another very similar DNA sequence that they would bind to, and so as a result, in extension, we get the DNA sequence we wanted in the first place. So now that you understand how nested PCR works, what do you think are the advantages and disadvantages of doing the technique? Well, while nested PCR is great for improving the specificity of the reaction, it can be quite costly and also time-consuming, because you have to do everything twice. Just to get an idea, usually 35 cycles of PCR take around an hour to complete in the thermocycler, and of course that doesn't take into account the time you have to spend preparing the reaction. So that's just something to keep in mind. Okay, so this is it. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful and you would like to watch more videos on molecular biology or medicine in general, please subscribe. Thank you again, and see you soon.